My name is Ezias Biringar, and I'm from Chad. I'm a graduating senior studying public health and minoring in neuroscience. When I was in high school, I was supposed to go to France and study medicine there. And my father wanted me to have a different culture and try to learn a new language and see what it's like to be speaking or living in a English-speaking country. And so he decided to bring me here, like where he studied 30 years ago. And that's how I got here in the US, here specifically at the University of Kentucky. We all know that when you're an international student, you don't actually think about Kentucky. And so I came here like a basic pre-med student. You think of doing biology, right? And because it's like you take all the classes and you're good for medical school. But so when I was majoring in biology, actually I didn't feel like it would help me be the doctor I wanted to be, or like I was planning to be. But I wanted to be a doctor that actually care about my population, but not only on one patient, but just try to have an impact on a general population. And so that's why I found public health, which is literally, it's exactly like you take, because to go to medical school, you just have to take your prerequisite classes, but then all the classes that you take after are just extra classes. So I said, okay, so I can actually learn about strategies, all those kind of things to implement programs in a community, or even like health programs in a community, or like build a non-profit organizations, all those kind of things. So this is why I say, okay, I want to be that kind of doctor that I understand his patient, but also understands how health works in a community. And so this is how I ended up choosing my public health major. But I really wanted, and because of my interest in neuroscience and becoming a neurosurgeon, I said, okay, it can help me. So I said, okay, so I would just take it and do those two together. And so that's how I'm here today. I quickly bonded with Africans here on campus, right? And through the African Student Association. And so, like, I think it's an organization that really helped me, connect with other African students on campus. And so the good thing about the African Student Association is the fact that every weekend we had something to do. So like we're all the time together. When you come for the first time, you're under the protection of someone, kinda. And so like, even if when you don't have things to do, the person will tell you, oh, what do you have to do? Just come by my house and like we can just have fun, or like just watch TV and those kind of things. So like, even that was very meaningful and like helped me be part of a bigger community. And then through the African Student Association, I met other people, I met other friends, and like been part of other organizations. So yeah, I would say that the African Student Association really helped me connect with people here on campus. And the first thing was, the ice cream social organized by the International Center was a great place to meet other folks from like other countries, right? And when I came, like every time I talk to people and I tell them that 4 years ago, I didn't know any English back like in August 2014. People don't believe me because the way I talk, they think that I knew English before coming here, but no, I didn't know any English before coming here. I started the ESL program, and then yeah, now I'm graduating, and it's just, if you're determined and very driven, I would say that professors notice that, and they know, and they will approach you, or if you decide to approach them, they'll give you full support. And professors were always down to like help you when you don't understand anything, because it's hard and they know. And I feel like they had like study sessions to help you understand the material and all that. And this is the same for other science classes. So I feel like here at UK, professors really try to help students succeed, and mostly in research, because it gives you like a way to think critically. Oh, what did I miss here? How do I do for it to succeed? So I feel like professors are very good at doing that here, And personally, I love my mentor, Dr. Young Jung. I worked for her, like, in her lab for 4 years. And I feel like she taught me a lot. And again, it's thanks to her that I got to Harvard. So I'm very thankful for everything I've learned. And yeah, so here at UK, if you really want to do research and really want to succeed, I think you have all the tools to do so. It's something that you can ask all ambassadors, because they know. I told them, by the time I graduate, I will go to Harvard. I literally told them that. So it was my goal. They always believed in me, like Hajin and Vibs and Tien, like very, like, they're my closest friends. And they always, like, so they knew. And it was crazy when I actually got admitted there, because I was like, it was my first goal. And being able to reach that goal, achieve that goal, it was just like a wonderful feeling. I think I'll definitely miss UK. Yes, I'll definitely miss UK.